Remind us, Lord, that we are called to be your disciples.
As we worship this morning,
Through the ages, O God, you have called us to follow. You lead us to freedom, to hope, and peace. Enter our hearts again today, and lead us to your healing love, that we might serve you joyfully in this world that you have helped us to us. Amen.
Today we're going to pray for the Second Congregational Church, UCC, in Norway, and the First Baptist Church on Paris Hill. Does everybody know about the cycle of prayer? It's a list that goes around to all the churches in this area, and we take turns every week we pray for two churches for each other. So right before Christmas, I think we get prayed for, and today we're praying for our sister churches. Let us pray. Dear God, thank you for this day. We thank you for the friends and family that can be here with us worshiping your love. We pray for people traveling in these busy roads. Oh, we're all in a hurry these days, getting to where we need to be. Please be with them for safe travels. We pray for the joy of being here and these beautiful flowers that are grown right in our very town. Dear God, in defiance of corruption and falsehood, we commit to truth and integrity. We pray for honesty and uprightness. In defiance of apathy and hatred, we choose to be proactive in love. And we pray for understanding and peace to increase in our world. interest and human arrogance. We celebrate God's salvation and we pray for compassion and faith to increase in our world. In defiance of all that would oppose God's purpose among us, we choose again to follow Christ. And we continue to pray, not just now, but in all times, through Jesus Christ, who taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever.
Thank you. Psalm 112. Praise the Lord. Happy are those who fear the Lord, who greatly delight in his commandments. Their descendants will be mighty in the land. The generation of the upright will be blessed. Wealth and riches are in their houses, and their righteousness endures forever. They rise in the darkness as a light for the upright. They are gracious, merciful, and righteous. It is well with those who deal generously and lend, who conduct their affairs with justice. For the righteous will never be moved. They will be remembered forever. They are not afraid of evil tidings. Their hearts are firm, secure in the Lord. Their hearts are steady. They will not be afraid. In the end, they will look in triumph over their foes. They have distributed freely. They have given to the poor. Their righteousness endures forever. Their horn is exalted in honor. The wicked see it and are angry. They gnash their teeth and melt away. The desire of the wicked comes to nothing. And Hebrews. Let mutual love continue. Do not neglect to show hospitality to strangers, for by doing that, some have entertained angels without knowing it. Remember those who are in prison as though you were in prison with them, those who are being tortured as though you yourselves were being tortured. Let marriage be held in honor by all, and let the marriage bed be kept undefiled, for God will judge fornicators and adulterers. Keep your lives free from the love of money, and be content with what you have, for he has said, I will never leave you or forsake you. So we can say with confidence, the Lord is my helper. I will not be afraid. What can anyone do to me? Remember your leaders, those who spoke the word of God to you. Consider the outcome of their way of life and imitate their faith. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever. Through him, then, let us continually offer a sacrifice of praise to God, that is, the fruit of lips that confess his name. Do not neglect to do good and to share what you have, for such sacrifices are pleasing to God.
Our gospel reading today is Luke chapter 14, verses 1, and then 7 through 14. On one occasion, when Jesus was going to the house of a leader of the Pharisees to eat a meal on the Sabbath, they were watching him closely. When Jesus noticed how the guests chose the places of honor, he told them a parable. When you are invited by someone to a wedding banquet, do not sit down at the place of honor. In case someone more distinguished than you has been invited by your host. And the host who invited both of you may come and say to you, give this person your place. And then in disgrace, you would start to take the lower place. But when you are invited, go and sit down at the lowest place, so that when your host comes, he may say to you, friend, move up higher. Then you will be honored in the presence of all who sit at the table with you. For all who exalt themselves will be humbled, and those who humble themselves will be exalted. He said also to the one who had invited him, when you give a luncheon or a dinner. Do not invite your friends or your brothers or relatives or rich neighbors. In case they may invite you in return, you would be repaid. But when you give a banquet, invite the poor, the crippled, the lame, and the blind. And you will be blessed, because they cannot repay you, for you will be repaid at the resurrection of the righteous. Word of the Lord, thanks be to God. How many of us had a special seat in grade school? Maybe right up next to the teacher's desk. What about an assigned seat right up next to the bus driver? Or worse yet, what about a special stool in the corner, saved for us who thrive in mischief and naughtiness? John? What about rules of honor that we may have grown up with? I grew up with that you always let an older person sit in the front seat of the car. Or when we start a meal, you don't eat until the cook has been seated. It seems like seats and sitting have a lot to do with our manners. In today's story, Jesus is teaching on his way up to Jerusalem, and he stops at a leader of the Pharisees to this large banquet. And Jesus was being watched very closely. But also, Jesus is watching very closely. And if you can imagine it, he causes a controversy as he watches how the guests are vying for their seats at the table so that they might sit in the seats of honor. And first, Jesus tells them what not to do. Do not sit in a place of honor, because it could be very embarrassing when you're asked to move. And that happened to me. I was at this big church service one time, and I wanted to sit as close as I could to the choir. And I went right and found my seat, and somebody came along and said, "Excuse me, this is reserved for the choir." That was rather embarrassing. And then he tells us what to do. You sit in the lowest place of honor. And maybe, just maybe, you'd be asked to move up. Being humble is the whole point of this particular story. And just like Mrs. Dixon last week, telling that fantastic children's message, showing us firsthand how likely we are to blow up and pop like a balloon if we puff ourselves up too big. We get bigger than our britches. Jesus might be trying to show us that there usually seems to be some sort of leveling that comes along our way. And this is something that Jesus talks about all the time. Those who exalt themselves will be humbled, and those who are humbled will be exalted. Those who are first will be last, and those who are last will be first. Well, that was his first teaching in that meeting. The second was, Jesus addresses the host of the party and says, you should not invite just your friends and neighbors, relatives. No, he tells them, you should invite the lame, the crippled, and the blind. And what's really unfortunate is that few of us do that these days. In fact, it's one of the teachings that is neglected, and we don't take it seriously. Now, everyone was curious about what these were for. These were someone's dream of doing exactly what Jesus is teaching here, inviting lame and the blind, to eat at the table with fellowship and providing teachings. Unfortunately, today we have regulations and liabilities that may prevent us from doing public suppers at the church now, but that does not excuse us from finding other ways. Because Jesus is telling us right here, those who find ways of feeding the poor and the lame and the blind are showing us signs of the kingdom of God. Because in the kingdom of God, the poor and the lame and the blind are welcome to this great banquet. And they will be highly respected, and they are given great places of honor. So often we look up to people, and so often we look down on people. And who are we to decide if someone is good and someone is bad? When we put people up on a pedestal, we lose the essence of who they are. And when we put people down below us, we're not following God in our hearts. God cares deeply how we live together. And what stands out in my mind about the celebration of life for our Oxford saint yesterday is that Lois was a near-perfect example of today's teachings. Lois always took care of the poor and the lame and the blind in a humble way. And that is exactly why so many people traveled from near and far to be with us, to exalt her, to share stories again and again of her love of all people and her humility. And for those of you who don't know Lois, who didn't know Lois, she was this incredibly special woman. In fact, in my mind, she was as close to following Jesus' teachings as anyone I know. Sometimes in a devilish way, but always spreading love with her hugs and smiles. In my years as a member here, and as my time as a pastor, I have never ever seen anything like the reception following the service in Fellowship Hall. The energy, the din of laughter and storytelling, sandwiches, salads, kids, big kids enjoying ice cream sundaes, the connecting, the reconnecting. I can only imagine that this is what it must have been like back in the day after Sunday worship. I believe that Lois's love and this beautiful family she created gave us this amazing opportunity to feel what it was like. But not just to remember the good old days, but to show us what can happen again. One of the nicest things I saw yesterday was the neighborhood directly around the cabin on the lake, all coming together for her special day. Very different people, different interests, different backgrounds. Maybe they never would have even met if they hadn't lived next to each other. But here they were, together, taking care of each other, loving each other, watching each other's back. And that's what I want for us. I want to be the kind of church that watches the community's back, taking care of each other, loving each other. A church that's open and busy with an energy that attracts those in the neighborhood. When people walk their dogs by, or they're staying next door at the bed and breakfast, I want to get their attention to the point that they're saying, "Wow, I wonder what's going on over there. Sounds like fun. I want some of that. Why is everyone so happy when they're leaving that building? Why are so many people hurrying to go in?" I'd like to think we're taking a shift. Great things can be happening here. I'd like to bottle that energy from yesterday's service and use it again and again. Maybe we'll decide that we can host the Girl Scouts here or hold AA meetings, tutoring, program from homeschoolers, who knows? The more that we do here, the more we will attract those who need us, those who need to be introduced to Jesus' teachings, to God's love, and to the Holy Spirit, which is speaking in this church loudly and clearly. And we need to act on it. We need to live into this calling. We have some amazing people stepping up who love this church. They love this community. Maybe they went to Sunday school here, or they come up for summers and plan to retire here. We are so abundantly blessed, and we need to make the most of our resources to fulfill the mission of this church. Because we are not done yet. And in some ways, we are just beginning. Amen.
Thank you.
in service in God's world, helping those in need, sharing the gifts you have been given. Go in love, bring hope to all.